Welcome to the podcast for Brain and Cortland in the Morning on 98.1 K-Hawk.
Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Back then, right now, from Tyler Hubbard. Good morning, it's Brain and Cortland. Welcome to Wednesday, everybody.
Man, I did not sleep well last night, and I think part of that was because I could sense that someone was staring at me in my sleep.
Other than Tater?
It was Tater.
Oh, okay. I'm like, I got a little nervous there for a second.
Sometimes when he has to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night, he'll, you know, wake me up by sitting on me or licking my nose. Didn't do that.
Just stared.
Instead, he was just staring. I woke up and he was like 2 inches from my face, just staring at me.
Hey, if you're not doing anything right now.
And then he wanted to go out and spend 15 minutes running around the yard.
Well, of course.
Chasing bugs.
It's a beautiful night.
Oh, my gosh. I was just like, can we go back to sleep, please? I'm so tired.
I didn't sleep well last night either for a completely different reason. Because it's Return of the Gout. What? Return of the Gout.
I just thought it was so funny when I came in this morning and I threw you your Chiefs hat.
Yeah,
you
did.
I bought you in Nashville.
Awesome.
So you can wear that now. But you said, I can't get up. I've got the gout. And I thought you were joking.
I wish I was joking.
Do you know how you got the gout?
I do. I care not to reveal it on the air.
Okay, what?
You know, no, listen.
What food or beverage was it, though?
It's beer.
Oh, okay.
It's beer. And maybe a margarita. And I don't want people to think that I drank to excess.
No, you just have no tolerance now.
No, I don't.
When it comes to your toe.
Over the course. I know, isn't that so weird?
My toe is intolerant.
That's right, it is. It's very intolerant. Over the course of 2 days, I had 4 drinks total. Isn't that crazy? Over the course of 2 days, I had 4 total drinks, and that's what pushed me over the edge. So anyway, the good news is I had medication at home. I took some in the middle of the night, and it is helping things improve. However, I am hobbling a bit today, so I apologize.
So you and your daughter are both
yes,
not able to run.
Oh,
currently.
My gosh. Well, I don't run anyway, unless my life is in imminent danger. But yeah, she runs for track. But yeah, we're both on the DL, so... For different reasons, mine self-inflicted. Sorry, I was coming into work today hobbling, and I'm like, you know what? Drinking just isn't worth it anymore.
Yeah.
It just,
well, you could also pre-treat.
Yeah, there's that.
I'm sure a lot of people do that.
Thanks, logic and reason for stepping into the conversation.
Anytime. Here I am.
It's Brandon Cortland on 98.1 K-Hawk. Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Mamaw's House, Thomas Rhett and Morgan Wallen. It's Brain and Cortland, and we are hooking you up with more tickets. Not just tickets. These are weekend passes to County Line Country Fest, which is happening in August.
Yeah, this is kind of a big deal because you don't get to just go see one concert and one opener. You get to see an endless number of concerts and openers over 3 days.
You get all the country music that your tired body will be able to handle by the time that festival is over. But, I mean, come on. It's a great time. It's in Prairie du Chien. And the headliners include Randy Houser, Parker McCollum, Tyler Hubbard. Nate Smith's going to be up there. It's going to be a great time.
It's a really good lineup.
And so what we're doing to give away these weekend passes, we got a little mashup each morning at 7:10. 3 songs from the artists that are going to be there. If you can identify the titles in the correct order, boom, you got weekend passes.
Boom.
Bam.
Bam. Wham.
I stopped at bam, but way to go,
Wham. Just trying to come up with more words.
Your chance to win them coming up at 7:10 this morning with your country concert leader, 98.1 K-Hawk. Kazow! Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Homegrown from Zach Brown Band. Good morning. It's Brain and Cortland on a Wednesday. And welcome to a segment we like to call What We Watched.
So I actually started something new yesterday.
Okay.
Not new, but new to me.
New to you. That's new.
Guess what I watched?
Star Wars, The Phantom Menace. I don't know what you watch. What are you watching?
Reba.
Are you really?
I've only seen a handful of episodes because, as I've said before, my mom used to like the show Reba, so she'd watch the reruns. So I've seen a few episodes here and there, but it's been a very long time. And yesterday I was looking for something new to watch, and I said, you know what, Reba? Why not? So I got through, I think, the first 2 episodes, and I'm already excited about it.
I classify Reba almost as it's a comfort show.
Yes, yeah.
She, no matter what Reba does, she's just so incredibly darn likable.
She is, and she's so funny, too.
Yeah, I just think that we are so lucky to have her And hasn't there been talk about somehow reviving that show?
Or some sort of reunion, maybe, or some something. Form or another. Yeah, I don't know. I've heard rumors, but I've also heard rumors about revivals and reunions with pretty much every popular show that's ever existed.
So I'm watching something that's new on Netflix. Netflix has been really getting into these live events. They had the live roast of Tom Brady on Sunday night.
Did you watch that?
I did. I watched a lot of it.
Okay, I watched a few clips, and it looked really funny.
I mean, it's funny, and it is not for young eyes or ears. And the other thing that that Netflix is doing is a new series featuring one of our favorite comedians, John Mulaney, and it's called Everybody Lives in L.A., hosted by John Mulaney. It's a live one-hour variety show, and he kicked it off last Friday. He did another show on, I think, Sunday, and another show last night.
So what's, I mean, how does it work?
So basically, it's just, it's weird. It's weird and funny. So basically, he hosts this variety show, and each night has a theme. The first night's theme was coyotes in Los Angeles. And so he has comedians, musicians, and also he has experts on the night's topic in L.A., and he takes live phone calls like a radio talk show.
Are you kidding me?
It's amazing. And at the end of every phone call, Mulaney goes, all right, what kind of car do you drive? And then he judges people on the car they drive. It is so...
I don't understand.
You don't have to. Netflix did. And so some of his guests have included Jon Stewart was on an episode. Gabriel Iglesias, the comedian, was on another episode.
Fluffy.
Yes. And so one night he talked about palm trees in Los Angeles. And how did you realize that all the palm trees in L.A., they're not native? They were all planted there 100 years ago to beautify the city.
Interesting.
And now they're all dying and they're contemplating on whether or not to replace them. Things you would never have known.
This is interesting. Because he's a comedian.
He is. And it's just, and it's Mulaney. So you know it's smart and funny. And it's just, it's unlike anything you've ever seen.
So there's more episodes still to come.
So his last episode is coming up on May 10th. So there's a live episode, Friday. But you can go back and watch them. If you don't catch them live, they're on Netflix for you to watch. So
okay,
well, you need to get a little Netflix action going on.
I just don't want to pay for Netflix. I've also heard good things about that baby reindeer show.
Yeah.
And I want to watch that one too, but I just haven't, I don't know, I haven't done it yet.
Streaming. That's how they get you.
I'm already paying for so many other streaming services.
You should check with your cell provider and see if you get any free services through them.
I don't think
that's how I get Netflix for free. So.
I got 3 free months of Apple TV Plus and I never watched one thing on it. So
well done. It's Brandon Cortland on 98.1 K-Hawk. Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Tucson Too Late from Jordan Davis. Good morning. It's Brandon Cortland. And for those of you who remember Caitlin Clark's introductory press conference after being drafted number one overall by the Indiana Fever in the WNBA draft, I remember watching it. It was her first time in Indianapolis. She was meeting the local sports reporters from both TV and print media. And she was taking questions, and Greg Doyle from the Indianapolis Star had a bit of an awkward exchange with Caitlin Clark, and it wasn't Caitlin's fault.
No, it was uncomfortable to watch, though.
Yeah, we have audio. If you forgot what it was like, it's up on the K-Hawk app. I wasn't going to play it. Basically, what he did was he made the heart gesture towards Caitlin Clark, and Caitlin says, oh, do you like that? I did that and directed that towards my family in the stands all season long. And then Doyle said something to the effect of, well, if you do that towards me this season, we'll be just fine. And everyone's like, you can't say that stuff.
It just was weird.
It was weird. And everybody else.
It was
else,
like he didn't know what to say.
Yeah. And listen, I know there's been a lot said about Doyle. Obviously, we don't live in Indianapolis. We're not aware of what he's like. But reports are he can be a bit awkward. And this was certainly not something that he garnered positive reviews for. He was skewered online and said, you know, would you have asked a male athlete some sort of question like that? Well, probably not. And so it has been revealed that Doyle has officially been punished by the Indianapolis Star. He will not be allowed to attend Indiana Fever games, which means no access to press conferences for the entire year. Uh-oh. And he also is completing a 2-week suspension without pay for his actions. Now, to Doyle's credit, he has issued apologies both on social media, and he also wrote a column in the Indianapolis Star, saying that he wasn't aware until he viewed it himself, and he chastised himself for being quote-unquote part of the problem.
Mm-hmm.
And so at least it sounds like he is self-aware enough to know that, hey, I messed up and I can do better.
Well, that's good at least.
Because listen, you know, we've had this incredible movement and this incredible moment where women's sports has come to the forefront and has now become hugely popular, and it's being covered by more members of the media than ever before. And you've got a lot of people out there who maybe haven't covered female athletes as extensively as you have covered male athletes. And we need to learn that there maybe are ways that we don't act in press conferences, and Greg Doyle learning the hard way.
I don't think it's necessarily even just female athletes. I think sometimes when you watch some of these older episodes of these late night talk shows, some of the questions that are asked to the women are just so cringy.
Yeah.
That's the best word I can use. Just so cringy.
Yeah, and you know, I think we're trying to be better than that. You know, and as a journalist, you should be able to come up with better questions.
Yeah.
You know, than that anyway. So, if you want to relive the awkward interaction, it's up on the K-Hawk app as well as.
Why would you want to, though?
I don't know. It's brutal. As well as more information about his punishment. So, anyway, he will not be attending Indiana Fever games for the rest of the year. Brandon Cortland on 98.1 K-Hawk. Go on for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk, Cole Swindell. It's Brandon Cortland on Wednesday, which means tomorrow night is Dustin Lynch night in downtown Cedar Rapids.
Heck yeah. That's going to be a fun show at the McGrath Amphitheater.
Outdoor country music. Let's go.
Hopefully you took Friday off of work if you're going to the show, because why wouldn't you?
That's how you plan your weekend right there. So we're giving you your final chances to win tickets to go see Dustin Lynch on Thursday night. We're playing a medley of hits by Dustin. When you hear him, be caller number 10. It's as simple as that.
It's really actually easy this week.
And we're telling you when to call in. We're going to play that medley of hits right around 9:15 this morning.
Okay, so you have some time to prepare yourself mentally, emotionally, physically, whatever you got to do.
Get those dialing fingers ready. Although for most of you, it's one button.
I can see you over there stretching your fingers.
Look at this. Huh? Are you not impressed?
I am not.
Okay. Oh, that's honest. All right, so 9:15, your chance to win them this morning. We'll also have a chance to win tomorrow, day of show, bright and early. Once again, these are digital tickets. We'll just email them to you so you don't even have to come and see us.
Well, that's convenient.
Isn't it?
Way to go, us.
Yeah. Dustin Lynch downtown tomorrow night with your country concert leader, 98.1 K-Hawk. Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk, May We All, FGL and Tim McGraw. It is Brandon Cortland on a Wednesday morning, and we are getting close to something that is called Concert Week. And this has happened before, but we're approaching it once again, and it means very affordable concert tickets.
So Live Nation does this every year.
Yeah.
It's basically a markdown sale where they give away, well, not give away, but they give you the opportunity to buy $25 concert tickets for different artists in different cities.
Okay.
And this year, supposedly, there are over 5,000 concerts that they are going to have $25 tickets to.
So here is my first question. First of all, that's cool, because any of you out there trying to buy concert tickets, whether it's country shows or any other format, it's getting pricey.
Oh, absolutely. And some of these shows, they say it's 75% off the regular price of tickets.
Yeah, it's a fantastic deal. So who what shows in Iowa are we talking about?
All right, so we won't know the full list until this drops at, I believe, 10 o'clock this morning.
Okay.
But we do know, according to the Des Moines Register, some of the shows that in the Des Moines area.
Okay.
That includes Maren Morris at Vibrant Music Hall in Waukee on July 26th. Luke Bryan at Wells Fargo Arena in Des Moines on August 24th.
$25 Luke Bryan tickets. What's up with that?
Pink
Whoa.
Is also on the list.
Hey now.
That's also at Wells Fargo Arena in Des Moines on October 24th. And then Drive-By Truckers are going to be at the Val Air Ballroom in West Des Moines on October 29th. So those are just the ones that we know in the Des Moines area.
Okay.
I'm sure there will be more in Eastern Iowa and other areas of the state.
Yeah. And once again, these are Live Nation shows, so you can kind of look up and maybe take a guess and figure out what shows or concerts might be discounted with $25 tickets.
So this actually starts today at 10 a.m., like we mentioned, and it runs for a week.
Okay.
So you don't have to buy the tickets today, but I'm guessing they only have a limited amount for each show.
That's what I'm guessing.
I'm guessing it's just better to get them sooner rather than later.
So are these tickets in all different, are these the cheap seats or are they?
I have no idea.
You just have to kind of check and see which section your seats will be in.
Yes, because obviously they're not going to be doing front row tickets $25. If you just want to be in the audience.
Yeah.
Which in a lot of cases, I don't care where I sit as long as I'm there. We were all the way up in the nosebleeds for Zach Bryan a few weeks ago. Still had a great time.
We kept saying if the tornadoes were to take us.
It was just going
to
take us first.
We'd be the first ones
to
go.
That's how high up we were.
That is exactly right.
I think
right.
I got a nosebleed a little bit.
The clouds were touching my bald head. But yeah, we were there. And if you want $25 tickets, it's a great deal. Goes on sale at 10 a.m. today. And we'll have more information on all of the shows eventually that are going to go on sale. It's Concert Week 2024. Woo-hoo. It's Braden Cortlandt at K-Hawk. Cedar Rapids, number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk with Keith Urban and Long Hot Summer. Good morning. It's Braden Cortlandt. Time, once again, to give away a pair of weekend passes to County Line Country Fest, that country music festival coming to Prairie du Chien, Wisconsin, August 1st through 3rd.
So we've got Randy Houser, Tyler Hubbard,
sure.
Parmalee, Parker McCollum,
oh my,
and Nate Smith.
Yeah, baby.
He's on my bucket list right now of artists that I want to see. Everything he puts out is so good.
Yeah, he's fantastic. All going to be at County Line Country Fest. So we've got a montage of three songs we're playing for you every morning. And all you have to do is take a listen and correctly identify, name those three songs in the right order. Here is your montage this morning.
It took the good with all the bad. Never watch the sun go down. I'll leave my memories inside.
I don't know. I think this is pretty easy today.
I know all three artists, but okay, do it one more time.
Coming up with a song. Titles,
yes,
that's
yes,
right.
Yes.
It took the good with all the bad. Never watch the sun go down. I'll leave my memories inside.
All right, if you can come up with the titles to those three songs.
Struggling with number two.
You are going to County Line Country Fest. 365-3698. Hit the call us button on your 98.1 K-Hawk app. I'll fill in Cortland off the air after the titles of the three songs.
Don't tell me.
Okay. All right. Fine. Guess on your own. Good luck with your country concert leader, K-Hawk.
Five in Iowa City. It's Brain and Cortland.
Giving away County Line Country Fest tickets. Let's go to the phones.
K-Hawk, good morning. You are caller number 10. Who's this and where are you calling from?
Isaiah from Cedar Rapids.
All right, here we go. Take a listen.
It took the good with all the bad. Never watch the sun go down. I'll leave my memories inside.
What three songs do we have?
World on Fire, How Country Feels, and Burn It Down.
Yeah, baby!
Yes!
You nailed it!
Wow, got them faster than I did.
Yeah.
Congratulations. You're going to County Line Country Fest this August. Way to go.
Appreciate it.
Nice job, Isaiah. Once again, the songs this morning, World on Fire, How Country Feels, and Burn It Down from Parker McCollum. So another mashup with three different songs coming up. Cedar Rapids number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Played again from Luke Bryan. Good morning. It's Brady Cortland. Yesterday, we kicked off Listener Lunch in the month of May. We're at a brand new spot for Listener Lunch, and that is Stadium Bar and Grill right off of Rockford Road in Cedar Rapids.
Yeah, this is right across from Colonel Stadium, and I have never eaten here before.
Yeah.
But they recently, I think earlier this year, debuted a brand new menu, and we were able to try that menu for the first time yesterday. Gotta say, fantastic food.
Very.
It was... I don't know what I was expecting, but it was so good.
Yeah. I had one of the best chicken sandwiches I've ever had.
It was pickle brine.
Pickle brine. It's so good, folks. pickle in the brine.
Brain let me try a little piece of it, and it did taste very pickly, but in a good way.
Yeah, no, it wasn't overpowering, but then it had pickles on it with some cheese and some ranch sauce. Oh, man, it all worked together. We had nachos as an appetizer.
Great nachos. Two thumbs up. You know me. I'm very picky about my nachos. It's my favorite food.
And what was the other appetizer we ordered, too?
They were garlic parmesan pretzel bites.
Yeah. I could have eaten a whole basket of those.
By the way, the jacked mac and cheese.
Yeah.
Also very good. And I had a buffalo chicken wrap yesterday, so you know I had heartburn last night.
You were sweating during lunch.
It was worth it, though. It was so worth it. Everything we had was so good.
Yes. Shout out to Angie, our winner with Unity Point St. Luke's. And she and her coworkers enjoyed lunch with us yesterday as well at Stadium Bar and Grill. So, listen, we're there all May long. If you want to experience the new menu, all the great food, you can get entered to win Lister Lunch by entering on the 98.1 K-Hawk app.
However, we know that some of you are not able to come to Listener Lunch. It just doesn't work out with your schedule or your job or the location. So if you want to take yourself to lunch, we've got a chance for you to win a $50 gift card.
Or maybe you just don't want to talk to us.
I mean, you can still come to lunch and not talk to us. It's happened before.
Caller 10 right now gets that $50 gift card, 365-3698, or hit the call us button now using your 98.1 K-Hawk app. Brandon Cortland giving away free food to Stadium Bar and Grill.
Hey, Hawk, good morning. You are caller number 10.
Way to go.
Good deal.
Way to go. What is your name?
Derek Meyer.
Well, Derek, congrats. You got a $50 gift card to Stadium Bar and Grill in Cedar Rapids. Congrats, man.
Sweet.
Derek's like, yeah, I'm getting that chicken sandwich. He's already decided now, which is awesome. So.
Well, we highly recommend it. Brain actually said after the meal that it was one of the best chicken sandwiches he's ever had.
And in case you missed it at the top of the hour, I also said I kind of wanted to marry it.
You did.
Which is creepy and makes no sense, but that's kind of
me in a
nutshell.
I was hoping we were all going to forget about that.
Cedar Rapids, number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Jelly Roll in need of favor. Good morning. It's Brain and Cortland on a Wednesday morning. And that means it's time for another round of Cortland's Secret Sound.
Is it bad that I kind of dread playing this every week?
I don't know.
I get nervous about my sound effects.
It's kind of funny. Now, once again, you can play along in your car, at work. Get the K-Hawk app out and get ready to send in your guesses. Because I suck at guessing as much as she's terrible at doing sound effects, apparently.
First of all, how dare you?
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Was I out of place?
So today's sound effect, I actually chose while I was in Nashville, and it was because I was trying to describe something to somebody I was with, and so I attempted to do the sound effect, and I said, that would be a good one for Cortland's Secret Sound.
So, you've had some practice. I'm expecting this to be spot on.
Okay, well, you're expecting too much, but here we go.
Here's this week's Cortland's Secret Sound.
All right, I'm going to close my eyes and do
this. Yep, so am I. Okay.
All right. Ready?
Okay.
I can't look at your face.
No, you don't want to see my face.
Maybe I did a better job while I was on vacation.
Okay. Now, my initial thought is that sounds... Okay. Well, you're doing it some more.
Sorry, I was trying to work it out as they go.
Okay, my initial thought is it's something to do with a motorcycle?
No.
Dang it. I thought I nailed it.
No vehicles involved.
No vehicles involved? It sounded like a revving motor.
Okay, let me try it a different way.
Okay, a different way?
Whoosh, 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 whoosh.
Is it cars passing by on a highway?
Like I said, there's nothing to do with vehicles.
I'm out.
You don't have any other guesses?
What could it be? I mean, wow. Mark,
I haven't had one of these in my house in a long time.
So. Mark says, "Is it glass cleaner at bars?" I'm not sure what that means.
No.
No.
Well, it's the right track.
Okay. Somebody says blender.
Not a blender.
Vacuum cleaner, not a vacuum cleaner.
Not a vacuum cleaner.
Shop vac.
It is some sort of appliance.
It's an appliance.
But it's not an appliance that everybody owns.
Okay, one more time. With the clue it's an appliance, make the sound again.
They're, you know, there's like different stages.
It's not a blender?
Uh-uh.
Man. Is it a mixer?
No.
Hmm.
Okay, you're really bad at this.
I'm bad at this, and apparently some people on the K-Hawk app aren't helping me at all here. Hang on, more guesses coming through. Garbage disposal?
No.
Amanda said weed whacker. I just want to say that on the air because it's a funny term.
It's not a weed whacker.
Nope, no whacking going on here.
Although I do not own a weed whacker, so.
Okay. Listen, I don't think nobody's gotten it yet.
Okay.
You have stumped us.
Do you give up?
Food processor, somebody says.
Not a food processor.
Dishwasher!
That's it.
Maddie from Anamosa! Maddie nailed it. It's a dishwasher.
So the Airbnb we stayed at, they told us we had to load all of our dishes before we left and start the dishwasher.
Oh, okay.
And so I was like, yeah, you just got to like, you know, like turn it on. And people are like, what was that noise you were making? Man. And I said, that's the sound of the dishwasher, right? And they said, no, it's not.
Okay. All right. Well, as long as everybody else was like, oh, clearly that's a dishwasher, Cortland. Yeah, you nailed it. Of course it is.
Listen, somebody always gets it. I may have to give 87 clues first, but somebody gets it.
Shout out to Maddie. Shout out to Jenny from Anamosa, too. They both guessed dishwasher.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah. So we don't have a dishwasher at home. Well, like, I'm sorry.
I'm the dishwasher at my house.
I do, but her name is Holly. So anyway.
Oh, ha-ha, funny. That was a great joke. My wife's in the kitchen.
Loading the dishwasher means getting my wife drunk. Hey-o. Didn't you see me at the roast of Tom Brady?
Goodbye.
All right. Brandon Cortland on 98.1 K-Hawk.
Here's the latest on the singers who bring us America's music. It's Brandon Cortland's Country Quickies on 98.1 K-Hawk.
And we lead off with Lainey Wilson news. Told you yesterday that she is going to be occupying the location in Nashville, formerly known as FGL House. The Florida Georgia Line Bar and Restaurant has closed, taken over by Lainey Wilson. And now we know a little bit more about the establishment, including the name. Get ready for Bell Bottoms Up, a play, of course, on Gull Bottom Country, entitled to her previous album. Lainey announced today she's opening up her own bar. 3rd Avenue, just off of Broadway, is where Bell Bottoms Up will be located. Confirmation, it will be part of the TC Restaurant Group roster. It'll feature 2 stages and 4 bars. Lainey also is going to help curate the Cajun-inspired menu. It'll include flavors of her home state of Louisiana with crawfish, shrimp boils, and more. So, should be a pretty cool place. Get ready for Bell Bottoms Up in Nashville.
So the first round of performers for the 2024 ACM Awards were announced a couple of weeks ago. Names like Miranda Lambert, Chris Stapleton, Lainey Wilson, Cody Johnson, Jelly Roll, Jason Aldean, Kane Brown, and Thomas Rhett are all part of that first group. But yesterday, we got the second round of performers. This list includes Post Malone, Parker McCollum, Noah Kahan, and Kelsey Ballerini singing a duet. Nate Smith will sing with Avril Lavigne, and Blake Shelton and Gwen Stefani will be doing a song together as well.
Awesome.
Presenters and a few other performers are still to be announced. The ACM Awards are set to stream on Prime Video on May 16th and will be hosted by Reba, who will also be performing at the award show.
Hey, speaking of Reba, you know, there's been talk of a Reba sitcom reboot. Well, we're kind of getting one in a way because Reba is working with her friends at NBC. Of course, she's already on The Voice. And she's teaming up with another former Reba sitcom co-star, Melissa Peterman. They're going to share the small screen again. NBC has handed over a series order for a show called Happy's Place. And the show was created by Reba EP Kevin Abbott. It'll star McIntyre and Peterman and will air in 2024-2025, so the next television season. No premiere date has been yet announced, but hey, a new Reba sitcom and Melissa Peterman's going to be in it too, so that's kind of a Reba reunion, right?
Well, I'm glad I'm rewatching Reba right now so that I can brush up on the show.
You can discover the chemistry and then a new show next year.
So we don't usually hear any drama involving Carrie Underwood, but she got caught up in a little bit of a controversy on social media a couple of days ago. It all started when Carrie shared a photo of herself nursing a baby bird back to health. She wrote, about a week ago, a bird fell out of its nest outside my door. It was clearly way too young to take care of itself. We tried to put it back, but the next day, it was out of the nest again. This time, it was dead. It also had a sibling nearby. I figured the mother abandoned the nest because it smelled like humans. So I scooped up the bird and brought it inside. It was weak and scared. I gave it some liquid first because I thought it would be quite dehydrated. Next, I made a smoothie of dried larvae, boiled eggs, water, and a few berries. It soon started to gain strength, and its web feathers started growing. Now I feed it every time I walk by and clean up the messes. While a lot of people in the comments were commending Carrie for trying to help this little baby bird, there were a lot of other people who told her that she shouldn't have done any of this. She should have called a professional or an expert or a rehab facility to take care of this baby bird instead of taking it upon herself, because she's doing everything wrong and it's bad.
And to those people, I say, shut up. Now, listen.
You can't do anything on social media without people criticizing you.
You just can't. Carrie Underwood has a huge heart, and she was trying to do the right thing in her eyes.
And she was like, oh, look how cute this baby bird is. And then everyone's like, you're doing it wrong. How dare you?
Yeah.
Everybody's an expert.
Carrie, we support you.
Poor little baby bird.
And your efforts to save young birds everywhere. Those are your quickies this morning. It's Brain and Cortland on 98.1 K-Hawk. Peter Rabbit's number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Man made a bar. Morgan Wallen with Eric Church. It's Brain and Cortland. And we are definitely fortunate to have two hospitals within the city of Cedar Rapids. More medical facilities, including the University of Iowa Hospitals and Clinics, just to our south. And so twice a year, there is an organization, a company called Leapfrog, that releases hospital safety ratings for nearly 3,000 hospitals across the U.S.
Okay, and what are these safety ratings based on?
So some of the categories they look at include things like hand washing, entering prescriptions into a computer system, the availability of highly trained nurses, problems or situations that might arise during a surgery, infection rates within a hospital. There's all kinds of things that go into a hospital's quote-unquote grade. And nationally, unfortunately, the state of Iowa doesn't do great. Iowa came in ranked 44th in the nation, according to this study on hospital safety, which up one spot from last year at 45. Hey, we're trending in the right direction.
Hey.
So it takes a look at the hospitals and it gives them individual grades. Only one hospital in the state of Iowa got an A grade. And that's in Spencer Hospital, the only hospital in Iowa to get an A grade.
Is that because it's maybe a smaller hospital?
Possibly. Maybe they have a little better ability to keep closer track of safety issues there. Six Iowa hospitals got a grade of B. 17 got a grade of C. And that also included Unity Point St. Luke's Hospital here in Cedar Rapids, got a C grade. And then there were seven Iowa hospitals that got a grade of D. And that was the lowest ranking. Nobody got an F in the state of Iowa. Okay?
Everybody was passing.
Yeah. And so among the hospitals that got a D was Mercy Medical Center in Cedar Rapids. And so before you pass judgment, by the way, go to the K-Hawk app. We have the links up there to click on each hospital and check out their ratings. And I pulled up Mercy Medical Center's D rating. And they rank high in many areas. Don't think that it is an unsafe medical facility. But there are other categories where obviously they can do better and they can make improvements according to this study. So I want people to go and look at this and not just say, oh, I'm never going there, because they have fantastic facilities at Mercy Medical Center. Their cancer center over there does wonderful things. My father was treated over there, for crying out loud. So, you know, don't think that just because they got a D that things are horrible. So we have all the rankings and ratings for each Iowa hospital up on the K-Hawk app if you're curious. So
interesting.
Yeah.
What about the other Cedar Rapids ones? Like Unity Point, what did they get?
They got a C. St. Luke's got a C. But once again, even though they had a higher grade, there are things that they can improve on too.
Okay.
So only those A students aced the test. So way to go, Spencer Hospital.
Where is Spencer?
Brown noser. Your A grade. I see what you're doing there. Keeping your patients really safe. You can read more about the study.
Know that Brain is being sarcastic.
Yes, I'm joking. Oh my God.
I'm like, all we need is somebody to call us and say, how dare you?
Please understand.
It was a joke. It was a joke.
You can read more about the study on the 98.1 K-Hawk app. It's number one for New Country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Fearless from Jackson Dean. It's Brain and Cortland. And with all these great concerts coming to the area, we've been talking a lot about Dustin Lynch tomorrow night in Cedar Rapids. Another great show coming to Coralville later this month, and that would be Ian Munsick.
I keep forgetting about this one, yeah. But it's going to be a great show. I feel like Ian Munsick has really gained a lot of popularity these past couple of years.
Yeah.
He's one of those artists where you may not know him very well yet, but he's got a cult following.
Absolutely. Also, he had a duet with Cody Johnson, mm-hmm. Which I think helped him a little bit in the visibility department.
Absolutely.
So Ian Munsick going to be at Extreme Arena in Coralville on Friday, May 24th. We've got a chance to win a 4-pack of tickets by signing up on the K-Hawk app.
And then one of the winners of the tickets will also get 4 meet and greet passes, yes. Which is super exciting. You and 3 of your friends getting to meet somebody famous on a Friday night country show in Eastern Iowa.
Yeah.
Does it get any better than that?
It does not. Once again, 2 winners of 4 packs of tickets to see Ian Munsick, 1 winner of 4 meet and greets. It could be you. Sign up to win right now on the 98.1 K-Hawk app.
Hey, all, good morning. You are caller number 10.
Awesome. No way.
Yes way.
Way, way. What's your name?
Awesome. My name's Jeff.
Jeff, congrats. You've got tickets, our second to last pair, to see Dustin Lynch tomorrow night in Cedar Rapids.
All right. Thank you very much.
And that means only 1 more pair tomorrow. Remember, it's day of show, but these are digital tickets. We'll email them right to you tomorrow morning.
Yeah, just make sure you give us the correct email.
Yeah. 6:30. 6:30 tomorrow morning, your last chance to win Dustin Lynch tickets with your country concert leader, 98.1 K-Hawk. Cedar Rapids, number 1 for new country, 98.1 K-Hawk. Jordan Davis with Tucson Too Late. Brandon Cortland wrapping things up right on time here on a Wednesday morning.
All right. We did it.
I love it when the gout medication works. It's a feeling of relief washing over my body, but especially my toe.
Are you not on steroids?
I'm on a different kind of medicine. You know, usually they put me on prednisone, but then
then you start raging.
Yeah. My blood pressure goes up and
you start getting mad about nothing and then yelling at me because I'm the only one in here to listen.
So, and you know what? What's weird is that stuff kind of happened at home too, Corlin. You wouldn't believe it, but it did. And so anyway, my doctor last time he said, hey, let's try something different. It is still an anti-inflammatory. I can't pronounce what it is, but yeah, it's not prednisone. And so far it's working. And that's all that matters. And I haven't yelled at you all morning.
Yeah. It feels great. Thank you so much.
You are welcome. All right. We're getting out of here. Dad joke to leave us with on a Wednesday.
Okay, Brain. How do you make Budweiser?
Make it study?
Send him to school.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That wasn't a very good one. They can't all be good, okay? There's only so many dad jokes in the world.
We're running through a lot of them, too. All right, back tomorrow morning, bright and early at 5 a.m. Until then, have a great day. So long.